A California restaurant allegedly hired a random guy to impersonate a priest to encourage employees to confess their sins against their employer. I wish I was making this up. I very much am not. The incident concerns the company Che Garibaldi Incorporated, which operates two Taquiera Garibaldi restaurants in Sacramento and one in Roseville. According to Catholic News Agency, which is not necessarily a source I ever thought I would be citing, during the Department of Labor's litigation in federal court, an employee testified that in November 2021, restaurant operator Eduardo Hernandez offered a person identified as a priest to hear confessions during work hours. Now, Maria Parra, a server at Taquiera Garibaldi, said in a sworn affidavit, "I found the conversation to be strange and unlike normal confessions. He asked if I ever got pulled over for speeding, if I drank alcohol, or if I had stolen anything. The priest mostly had work-related questions, which I thought was strange." According to the employee, that supposed priest urged employees to get the sins out. He asked them if they had stolen from their employer, been late for work, or done anything to harm their employer. The purported priest also asked if they had bad intentions toward their employer, the Department of Labor said. Now, I'll just pause here and say, I was raised Catholic. I went through all the sacraments, and except for death, I haven't done that or gotten married. But I did go to confession pretty regularly when I was younger. I never had a priest ask me a single question. I just said, I don't know, I didn't listen to my mom sometimes. And he was like, all right, do it, our Father, and you're cured. I've never had a priest press me to give more information. So she was absolutely right to be tipped off that some is not copacetic with what's going on here. But it wasn't just her, it was several workers who felt that Hernandez had brought in the priest to intimidate them. But it wasn't that. It turned out this dude was not even a priest. Bryan J, Visitacion, director of media and communications for the Diocese of Sacramento, confirmed that this guy was not a priest. And he said, our own investigation found no evidence of any connection between the Diocese of Sacramento and the alleged priest in this matter. While we don't know who the person in question was, we are completely confident he was not a priest of the Diocese of Sacramento. The US Department of Labor on June 12th said the use of the supposed priest was among the most shameless of corrupt actions employers have used against employees. And that is a damn high bar, okay? That bar is the sky. So to be the most shameless, wow, wow. Mark Piloton, the Department of Labor's regional solicitor who litigated the case, said that in addition to the restaurant offering a supposed priest, other employees reported that a manager falsely claimed that immigration issues would be raised by the department's investigation. So not only are they bringing forth a fake priest so that these employees will confess their sins against the company, they're also insinuating that if they cooperate with the, not insinuating, explicitly saying, if they cooperate with the investigation into this fake priest, that they might get deported, that their family might get deported. So this is, I mean, it's funny on its face, but it's also deeply sinister. And I think the most upsetting part for me is this last bit about what their penalty is. US Judge William B. Shubb on May 8th ordered Che Garibaldi LLC and its operators Eduardo Hernandez, Hector Manuel Martinez Galindo, and Alejandro Rodriguez to pay $70,000 in back wages and $70,000 in damages to 35 employees. In addition, the restaurant and its owners must pay $5,000 in civil penalties to the Department of Labor. Cenk, that is insultingly low. That is an insultingly small amount of money.
Yeah, so I don't know how gigantic this company is. But yes, that is as egregious as it gets. So the fine should have been commensurate with the crime here. I mean, this is just mental. So what were they, look, I think that there's two reasons why the priest only asked questions about work. One is obvious, because he wanted to find out if they were doing something wrong at work. That was the whole point of the fake priest, right? But as I was reading the story, I thought there's probably a second reason. It's because he didn't want them to confess other things, like potentially crimes or something about their private lives and their family. Because imagine, I mean, if they think he's a real priest and they're doing a real confession, what if the guy starts getting into, this is what I did to my wife and this is what I did to my neighbor? Whoa, no, don't tell me, right? So, and what if some of them did tell? This is, like, of all the crazy things I've seen companies do, I get hats off to the anti-Che Guevara company, the Che Garibaldi company. I mean, they're like, okay. I don't know if they were trying to rescue the name Che for late stage capitalism, but this is one of the most egregious things I've ever seen. Full blown mental.
I didn't even think about that. I didn't even consider, what if someone was like, forgive me, Father, for I have sinned. It's been, I don't know, 6 weeks since my last confession. I killed my neighbor.
It's not impossible, right?
That person has to tell the police.
Yeah, especially because they're not a priest. So there's no exception to, and so they must report the crime. I mean, this is just, it's very poorly thought out. It is as abusive to your employees as you could possibly imagine. And look, I'm not a person who believes in confession. I didn't grow up Catholic. I've always thought it was super weird. I get it, in the old days, it's basically like the substitute for therapists. And so it has some value in people venting and etc. But I got news for you, just randomly telling your sins or your secrets to a dude that wears a funny outfit isn't going to affect the mythical creature in the sky in terms of your judgment. But hey, that's just me. And I've never believed that those confessions wouldn't be used against people. I'm sure that most of them weren't. I'm sure that most of the priests, I hope, cross your fingers, were good guys and they, you know, and they kept things. But are you telling me that it was never used for bets? Are you crazy? I bet you a giant percentage of it were used by actual priests against folks. So word to the wise, you know, I'm not big on the confessions part overall. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.